and on the snooker hall as 48 came to the fray to fight with cue and ball. From Earth's four corners, there they came to feud in this most testing game.
You could be happy, and I won't know. But you weren't happy the day I watched you go. And all the things that I wish I had known.
My overall form of the match is just disgusting, really. I don't think I deserve the win.
Is it too late to remind you, gentle power? Not our last days of silence, scream and blur. Most of what I remember makes me sure. I should have stopped you from walking out the door. You could be happy.
Three.
I hope you are.
Both paddles.
You made me happier than I've been by far. Somehow everything I
felt very flat. Couldn't hold my concentration, felt awful. So I'm just glad I'm going home.
And for the tiniest moment, it's all
true. Well done.
If it comes this week, then I feel good, and I'll go with it. If I don't, then I'm not going to sit here and kill myself to get a result.
Our own Welsh warriors gathered with all their skill to fight. Ian, Matthew, Mark and Ryan Day. To evangelic night, they are with other warriors cast. But 16 make it to the last.
Please don't let this turn into something it's not. I can only give you everything I've got. I can't be as sorry as you think I should. But I still love you.
It's been pretty good to know you today.
It's nice to come here, always a good crowd. We know they're snooker. I'd love to win, but listen, I'd love to get through the quarterfinal.
All that I keep thinking throughout the top flight. Could take my whole damn life and it's right. The splintered mast I'm holding on won't save me long. Because I know fine well that what I did was wrong.
Anytime you beat Stephen Hendry is a great result, but to win the way I did in probably the highest quality match of the tournament so far in terms of two people playing really well. I'm very pleased to get through, and obviously he'd beaten me a couple of times sort of pretty easily before this. So definitely a relief to get through.
Eight men are left in Newport still standing by the green, and of them he, O'Sullivan, among these greats is seen. But in the end, will he have won? Or this unknown called Higginson?
Hitting a 147, even when you get them in practice, it's a feeling, it's a perfect frame snooker. So when you do it, even in practice, as I say, the buzz you get is amazing.
As long as I'm playing to my standards, and you know, I really don't, you know, I don't play on a pattern. You know, I play balls. Give me a cue and a stick. Give me a bit of rhythm, a bit of form, and I'll beat anybody.
Four doughty knights, unyielding on cue, come to the hall to combat for true honour. A semi-final fall for any superclass of warrior is nothing short of lowly failure. The green is full of colour, and it's the final scene in this titanic clash of cues. None better will have been. Will Robertson, who's great of might, or Higginson, who's full of fight, be best in Newport on the night?
He's young, he's gifted, and he's Australian. Neil Robertson is surfing the crest of a wave, and he defeated six times world champion Steve Davis to reach the Welsh Open final. Andrew Higginson has only ever seen a major snooker final on television, but now he's taking part in one after beating Steve Maguire to extend a giant-killing run that's defied belief. Robertson vying for a title? Well, that's no surprise after his Grand Prix triumph in October. But Higginson's progress has been nothing short of astounding. He was a 500-1 pre-tournament outsider. Higginson's prevailed in both of their previous encounters, but don't read too much into that. Robertson's improved tremendously in recent times. It's the best of 17 frames. Here's the first with commentary from Darren Morgan and Clive Everton.
Just off straight.
One. Perfect accuracy. Pink and black weren't available.
Neil Robertson.
And in fact, Robertson hit that long pot so well, he actually got the cue ball back into balk, whereas just short of the balk line would have given him choice of low-value colours. Andrew Higginson playing his 10th match in this event. Four rounds of qualifying and five rounds here. He survived. The Newport Centre is the venue. Not quite full, but certainly a goodly crowd. Higginson, though, slightly misjudged his escape. Meant to leave the cue ball safe in that back row of reds.
That's an hard thing to do, Neil Robertson, and then stop yourself on the final backswing. He made up his mind he was going to play the red to the middle, and then just stopped at the last minute. Well, looking at that, it's very tight.
Well, there was a key shot in last evening's semi-final, which eventually Stephen Maguire played, and it turned out that a vital black wasn't, in fact, possible. Robertson, after a lot of consideration, decided against his original choice.
Clive, look how the game's changed. He rolled that red into the middle, left himself that long blue to the green pocket, just stroked it in, no effort at all. He does like going for his shots, Neil Robertson. Trouble is, he gets most of them.
Seven.
If he wins today, Robertson will be seventh in the provisional world rankings, eighth if he loses.
Thank you. 18.
Well, it was always going to be very difficult to predict where the cue ball was going to finish from that shot.
Yes, he'll have been hoping that with all the power and right-hand side he had on that cue ball, if he could have got the cue ball to the cush with any kind of strength on it, the cue ball would have gone a lot closer to this blue. Still no problem. Just needs to land on a red. It's a nice shot at this one to the bottom of the black.
24.
Has this been a good start by Neil Robertson?
Yes, when he's needed to give a shot lengthy consideration, he has. He realises the importance
25.
Of imposing himself from the outset against his less experienced opponent.
Both these players play them shots 31. Into the middle pockets with so much confidence. Don't just dolly him in, they give him a right whack.
Sure. 32.
Michaela Tabb comes forward to clean the cue ball. A landmark day for her. Today she becomes the first woman ever to referee a world ranking final. A thoroughly deserved appointment. She's reached
37.
A very high standard. If she makes a mistake, we can now vilify her just as we would a man. With no allowance for gender.
Forty-five. 76. Neil Robertson, 76 and nothing.
Very impressive indeed. With that break of 76, Neil Robertson leads by a frame to nil.
Second frame, Neil Robertson to break.
Robertson's break-off shot only just about reaching the balk line.
Yes, and Andrew really needs to knock this red in and try and stamp his authority. And he's a little bit out with that one, but he did only play two shots in the previous frame. Like Terry said, the minute he gets his first frame on the board, he'll settle down, I'm sure.
One.
Cue ball was running unpredictably free off the thin edge that was needed for the pot.
Neil Robertson, one.
Shouldn't be too difficult though to leave the cue ball safe in the back of the bunch. I think the question is not just how well will Higginson play, but how well will he be allowed to play?
I couldn't agree more, Clive. But obviously, for him to have any chance in this match, he does need to get off to a good start. The last thing you want to do is go too many frames behind. He's never experienced this before. Mind, Neil Robertson's only experienced it once. But the way he started that first frame, it holds no illusions for Neil Robertson.
Dave Higginson, Andrew's father, in his lucky seat, the seat that he's occupied for all his son's matches on this table this week. Pot them all. Certainly wasn't easy.
One.
So that's Andrew Higginson's first pot of this year's Welsh Open final. And you would have to say the balls couldn't be spread any nicer. Just pop this red in the middle now and go down for the black.
Three. Four.
This is a great chance, Clive, for him to settle himself down.
Yes, it's early in the match, but it is an important visit, this, because if he doesn't make much of it, a few doubts may start to creep in. But Higginson has attributed this late resurgence in his career to an ability to play the balls and not the occasion or the opponent.
Thing is, Clive, don't matter what opponent
17.
He's playing against, when he's sat in his chair, don't matter how good he is, he cannot do anything to you whatsoever.
18.
So Neil can only sit there and watch and hope that he's going to get another opportunity in this frame, but Andrew's looking very good here.
26.
The other thing that Higginson said this week about this late flowering in his career, was that he felt for years he's been giving his opponents
33.
Too much respect and forgetting what a good player he is himself.
34.
Well, has he screwed back far enough to be on the black? If not, the kick was to blame.
34. Yes, he's okay here, I think. Only just, though. So he's back in playing position now. Well, it didn't 41. Look like that was a kick from where we are sitting. Just looked like he stopped the cue a bit quick.
42. Three. 94.
Overran for the brown, which was his intended colour. Pink for the century.
100. 102. 105.
The 32nd century of the week in total.
109. 114.
After dropping the opening frame, Andrew Higginson has not only won the second, but won it in style with that excellent 114.
5. If these first two frames are anything to go by, this is going to be an absolute thriller. Both of them on top of their games. Anybody that was thinking that maybe the nerves would get the better of them, well, I'm afraid that illusion's been chucked out the window.
Yes, sometimes you see some player reach a very late stage of a tournament, a stage that he's not accustomed to, and after two or three good wins he blows up, but no sign of that from Higginson. The way he's played this week, it's as if an extra light has gone on in his head somehow or other.
Foul and a miss. Andrew Higginson, 5.
Robertson's attempted glancing escape fails.
What I've liked this week with both these players, when they play shots like this, if he takes the one to the right of the pink, He has got an option of two. He got the one to the left corner as well. Just all depends which one he fancies the better. But they play this as a punch run. And they give the balls quite a crack. Well, he's put it back. That's a bit of a surprise, Clive.
Yes, I guess one element which entered his mind was that the cue ball was fairly near the side cushion. But like you, Dan, I expected him to take it on because the red that he would have been attempting would have been the only one he could have left.
Okay, Andrew?
Yes, very surprised with that decision. There's no guarantees now that he's going to get a better opportunity than the last one. If Neil Robson gets the desired contact on his two-cushion get-out, he might even go for the red at the left corner. Feel he's forced into it. So he's took a big risk.
Well, Higginson could see the funny side of that. Very good shot from Robertson, but tactical error from Higginson.
Yeah, Robertson won.
Thing is, Clive, I fancied that if he had gone for the pot, Higginson, he'd have knocked it in, but terrific cue in.
I noticed that Robertson didn't fancy the cut-back black from the jaws of the corner pocket. Can't blame him for that. Generous applause for that well-executed safety from Higginson. It's fair to say that the neutrals in this audience are sympathetic to the underdog. Well, that's the overdog, but not at the moment. One all. 76 break Robertson first frame, 114 Higginson second frame. To play this with that with a trace of left hand side to avoid canning another red, and that made the pot more difficult.
Bad shot we've seen from Neil Robertson. He's cued right across this. Missed that one by a long, long way.
One.
Yes, I think Robertson was using left of centre striking as well. Have to be very careful using off centre striking on these super fine cloths, but sometimes you have to for positional reasons.
Six. 7.
Yes, there's the left of centre striking. Got well through the ball, which is one of the secrets to controlling it, but still difficult. And the outcome is that Higginson is in round the black spot.
14. Andrew Higginson, 14.
The red didn't have far to travel to the pocket, but you really do have to be careful with those along the rail on these championship tables.
I agree, Clive. And obviously he was only cueing half the cue ball as well, due to it landing on the red to the top cushion, but you'd have still fancied him getting that one. But looking at the way Neil Robertson's walking around, have a little look, it looks like he might have got away with that, Higginson.
Can't get through to what would otherwise be a simple red, just above the black.
That was a very well played shot. It looked like Higginson had got away with that, but due to that good pot, that's given Neil Robertson a terrific chance now.
Seven.
Well, as long as he can still get through to this red, no damage done.
Fifteen. Twenty-two. 23.
Oh, Clive, is he a great snooker player? He's got an hairstyle I'd have died for. But unfortunately for me, you need to have hair on the top of your head to get that sort of style.
29.
Pink spot not available, so the pink being replaced on the highest available spot, which is the green.
Thirty-seven. Forty-five.
Not perfect by any means. The black was straightish, so it needed quite a bit of power into that stun shot to get back for a red to the same pocket. He does have a red to the far corner, but it's far from easy.
Neil Robertson, 45.
So loss of position was at root responsible for bringing that potential frame-winning opportunity to an end. Yes, he was straightish on that black, so he really had to power the cue ball on and off the cushion. Didn't quite make it for his intended red.
That one, and he was a long way off. A lot of pressure on that last shot. He knew if he didn't pot the red, he's going to be leaving Neil Robertson an easy pot to the right corner, but
one.
So he didn't expect to get his second chance quite as quick as this, but you can feel assured. Robertson will be looking to wrap up this third frame with this effort.
Eight. Sixteen. 17. 24. 25.
So Higginson knows that he's going to be 2-1 down. Robertson struck the front in this frame with a 45 break.
37.
Higginson had a chance for a counter-attack.
38.
But missed a red to far corner, knowing that he was leaving the game at his opponent's mercy if he missed. And Robertson has duly
44
done the business.
46 49 53 58.
No doubt about it, Robertson has emerged this season as a player of authentic world class.
64.
He's still only 25 years of age. So Neil Robertson with breaks of 45 and 71 in that frame. Leads by 2 frames to 1.
Well, Robertson grabbed the next 2 frames as well, both on the colours to lead 4-1. Higginson needs to make his presence felt. John Evans and Dominic Dale are now at the microphone.
Super putt. Now then, look at this. Played as a shot to nothing as well. His white was back. Can he now add? Well played.
5.
Here, if Neil Robertson will screw this cue ball into the pack of reds, develop everything. Andrew Higginson, I should say. Played it quite well. Always had this red to the right corner. That's pretty much a guarantee.
13.
He did stress last night that he was going to enjoy every second of this final beyond his wildest dreams to have reached this stage, and what a tournament it's been for him. Applause, but what next?
19.
Yes, John, indeed, what next? He's been very unfortunate again. Could have had a choice of 2 reds into either of these black pockets, but there's a red just in front of both of them blocking the path. There is still a red on into this right-hand black pocket. It was a thin one. It's actually a red that's pretty much parallel with the cue ball, about a foot away from it. He'll be hoping he can advance the cue ball up for the blue here. He suggests a cannon.
20.
Very well recovered.
25. Andrew Higginson, 25.
Once again, an unexpected miss from Andrew Higginson. Dissimilar to the one he missed in the previous frame.
So the man they call the Melbourne machine is off again.
Seven.
Well, the black is available this end of the table. And the Reds giving him quite a few options.
10.
Gee, that was a lusty bounce off that side cushion. I don't think Neil Robertson expected the cue ball to be this far down the table. Having to play a very difficult red here into the right centre pocket.
Sound pot, but he's finished the wrong side of the blue. Does he have to go into balk or does he take another colour?
He's just concerned here that in attempting to take the cue ball around the angles in and out of balk for his next red, that he'll possibly collide with the yellow. May even take the yellow here. It's a natural angle to just rebound from the balk cushion back down towards the reds. No, he still likes the blue. I think the harder he hits this blue though, the nearer that cue ball's going to go to cannoning the yellow.
A wise choice. Will he now just nudge the two reds closest to the pink? Had other options. Doesn't have to do a great deal with his white.
21. 28.
Just a couple of minutes ago, Andrew Higginson was comfortable, holding a 25-mil lead. It's now been surpassed.
36. 37.
37. Well, that's the centre stage arena for these two players at the Newport Centre here. And as a player, it's always fantastic to have that one table set up.
42.
And all eyes are on you. Quite a good crowd in here as well this afternoon, it has to be said. 40. Trying to win his fifth frame of this final right here now. He's 42 points and still going in this effort.
43.
Lead of 18 points, and this is ominous signs now for Andrew Higginson. Just shows how quickly a match can begin to slip away from you. Just miss those two easy reds, one in each of these last two frames, which have allowed Robertson to amass this 4-1 lead.
49.
It's looking pretty good out there. Just this black, one more red and black, and it should be 5-1 Robertson. Won't need to worry too much about the red that's touching the pink there.
56.
It's the first player to nine who becomes this 2007 Welsh Open champion. So Neil Robertson will be over the halfway mark with this black.
64.
And I gather that tonight is a sellout.
65.
Nine frames are scheduled. But with a lead of 5-1 at the moment, one wonders how many frames will be played tonight. Let's hope that Higginson will stage
71.
A comeback now in the last two frames of this afternoon session.
73.
Again, the cleanliness of the pot, a feature that time.
76. 80. 85.
Robertson leading at the interval by 3 frames to 1. Now this is the second frame after the interval.
91.
The early lead by Andrew Higginson. Seemingly straightforward red. Mr. Blackford on pocket.
28 in the frame, Neil Robertson.
And then Neil Robertson stepping in and mopping up. And departs the arena. And what a week it's been for the young Aussie, Neil Robertson. It's not every week that you defeat three world champions. 7 times holder, Stephen Henry.
Andrew Higginson, 4.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6 times rather, Ronnie O'Sullivan, twice a world champion, and then Steve Davis in the semi-final. Six times a world champion. It'll go back. She reckons that she dropped one of her own hairs on the table.
Yes, it'd be fairly easy to identify, wouldn't it? It'd be about 4 foot long, I think. Her hair was probably touching all the bulk colours.
This way.
Both players and referee happy.
Yes, that's okay. Now's a chance here for Andrew Higginson to split a few of these reds open in playing this safety shot behind the green on the bulk cushion. Pretty well. Just not quite snookered near Robertson. I think he can just get through to red just to the right of the pack to get that cue ball back into bulk.
And Andrew Higginson can also just nick the pack if that is his desire. But an attacking shot, an attempt at a pot. What's the damage? Pot available, green pocket certainly. And black right hand.
Well, that's the red Neil Robertson would like to play. If he thinks it goes past the red that's here with the blue there, he's probably got two-thirds of the pocket to aim at. And it is pretty dead straight. Well, he's looking at one instead into the yellow pocket. Or will it go into the centre pocket? It went into centre, very acute angle that, but Neil preferred it because he didn't have anything to do with the cue ball there for position on the black. It was close, but he has left a tricky red into this right-hand corner for Higginson.
Neil Robertson has covered all the other options at a pot. Overcut. This could be trouble. Could be very expensive.
Yes, he's starting to struggle a little bit now, Andrew Higginson. Not easy when you're 5-1 down to somebody who's so full of confidence. Just hope he doesn't get a little bit too self-conscious and start worrying about the way he's playing and feeling the pressure out there, because this game can make you look rather silly sometimes. Once again, a little unfortunate. Don't think he's on anything that will pot. But he did just catch the right-hand side of the pack there. Just have a look at the cannon on the pink here. Just catches it to the right-hand side. And leaves everything blocking each other into the left-hand corner pocket, so...
Andrew Higginson, 10.
Only 10 points from that opportunity.
Solid safety, though. Onus back on Robertson.
Neil Robertson walking around the table to peruse the lie of the land, so to speak. He's in a bit of trouble here. The only way he can get back to bulk easily is off the red just below the pink, but if he didn't catch it very thin, he'd be cannon in the black, so it's very risky. So having to play what's called a containing safety shot instead, which is basically a safety shot that doesn't put your opponent in trouble, but doesn't leave him a pot on.
Has all the options though to nudge red and return to balk. Safe, but not a perfect weight. Third left red. This could be interesting.
There's a long red on here, the one that's near the black for Neil. And if he doesn't feel he can play a safety shot, he'll be going for it. It's very strange that he's such an attacking player, Neil Robertson. There was an instance where I thought the safety shot was harder than the pot. Had to thread the cue ball through the proverbial eye of a needle there. And the way he pots these long reds, thought he might have taken that one on instead.
One.
Came for the black. Gettable, but also missable. Should pot. I agree, Dominic.
Eight.
I'd have expected him to take that one on. Now, can he pot and hold for the black? If so, he's in business.
Nine. Sixteen. 24.
Nudge the one, and I believe from his gesture
32
that the red isn't available to the left hand pocket. Oh dear, it was a bad mistake.
Yes, it was, John. I don't know whether he can snick that red that's just to the right of the cue ball down the cushion. I think he's tried to catch that red full ball, and he's just caught it to the right-hand side, nudged it onto the cushion, and the cue ball up against another red. And I'm sure if you asked Andrew, he'd be disgusted with himself, not leaving himself a choice of reds there.
Andrew Higginson, 32.
Sometimes you try to push a boat out too far in those situations. You're so frustrated at not keeping the boat going. And try somehow to pot a very difficult ball that you wouldn't normally go for. But there, you did exercise caution.
This now has all the makings of quite a long frame, with the six remaining reds all along this near rail. One in centre table. Whilst escaping, you might dislodge a red or two.
Oh, what a shot.
Intended, yes. But an element of luck as well, Dominic.
Well, not really. He did actually attempt to get the cue ball in behind the yellow there, but I hear what you say. It's not something you can guarantee happening, but it was a great shot. I don't think Neil Robertson was too impressed when he came to the table, the look on his face. He thought, oh my god, what do I do here? This will be extremely difficult to escape from, which is why you won't even see me attempt to use my telestrator. There are so many different ways you could try and escape from this, but well, he's played this well. I think this could be excellent, and is. Still left a red on into the left corner. But he'd be very happy with that, as good as he could have done.
I believe the red is available. In fact, it is never easy along the cushion, and he has to go along the table as well for his colour.
Good part.
Deserves his colour. In and out of balk. Settles for the gentle answer to that query.
7.
A couple of good ones in this little break of 8, Andrew. And can he get on the red by the black? What's that cue ball to run? That's pretty good. So
14.
The red and the pink. It could be 5-2. In goes 15. The red. Pink would give him a lead of 59 points. But there'll still be 59 left. He's not getting much luck when he cannons reds, is he? But he'll feel fairly secure.
21.
In the knowledge that his opponent would need 4 reds, 4 blacks and the remaining 6 colours to only tie the frame.
Andrew Higginson, 21.
Attempted the difficult pot to the little bag, which would have assured the frame for him, but concentrated as well on ensuring that his white was safe.
In. Neil Robertson taking this red on really because he has to get on the black. So may try and bring one or two of these more difficult reds into play with a good safety shot.
That should be frame indeed. Robertson has conceded with 59 possible points left on table. At last then, Andrew Higginson wins a frame.
Neil Robertson to break.
Robertson accounted for the next with a 74 break to lead 6-2 after the opening session, but Higginson's not about to crumble and secure the first frame of the evening with runs of 54 and 36. We rejoin the action at the start of the 10th with John Evans, now accompanied by Darren Morgan, in the commentary box.
The break by the young man from Australia. His parents out in Melbourne, by the way. Now, this afternoon, Darren, the little nudges didn't go his way. They are so vital. Missed that time, but the white has gone comparatively safe. I'm not saying that it is 100% safe.
Yes, John, but I think Neil Robertson would rather the shot he's left with than that red found his way into the corner pocket and Andrew Higginson carrying on from where he left off in the last frame, so... But you are right, there was a lot of horrible kisses he had this afternoon, which didn't help his cause, but Neil played very well. Well deserved with his lead of 6-2.
biding his time for his first real opportunity.
He's left this red to the left corner. Neil will be playing this with the right hand side to check the cue ball. I can't imagine him trying to drag around the back. Oh, the way he's cueing up. Well, that's the way he's played the shot, but he's been very fortunate for that cue ball to find a path through. There's always a possibility of Cannon in them two balls near that top cushion. Thing is, due to the black and the pink being tied up, he won't really want to move this blue into a pot in position, but we might see him come half ball off the blue and try and get in behind the brown and the yellow.
Neil Robertson.
He's left the blue there. He's tied up yellow and green now, so we could be in for a bit of a low score in frame.
Great pots, of course, very attractive, but this defensive display also extremely acceptable. And fascinating. What have we here? Something of a Chinese snooker. Bridging very awkward. But the pot not too difficult.
One.
Very awkward striking then. Down on the cue ball. He's got a tendency to flick a little bit of side on, which then sends the cue ball the opposite way. Horrible shot, even though that red was close to the middle pocket. Well, at the moment, the small Andrew Higginson.
Seven.
I don't know whether you'd agree, John, but compared to this afternoon, he looks a lot looser out there. He looks a lot more relaxed.
I would. In some ways, Darren, it's his sort of second appearance in the final, as it were. He made his 11. Debut this afternoon, but now he's more at home. Seemingly so, anyway, so far.
12.
Perhaps the fact that he's or was 6-2 behind is less pressure in some way. He's more relaxed.
Yes, well, that goes without saying. He's probably come out tonight and thought, well, I'm just going to enjoy it and see what happens. 6-2 down. He knows he's nearly at the point of no return. So if he can come out and pinch one and then maybe pinch another one, all of a sudden he's back in this match. But pressure's a funny thing. And if he does get right back into the match, he'll start to think then that he can win as well. And it sort of transfers again. So I think Neil Robertson's just going to have to be patient and... hope that Andrew Higginson's charge comes to a halt.
25.
Now the black is in play. Just been potted for the first time in the frame.
26.
Next two red straight forward.
33, 34. This is how Andrew Higginson 41. Has played all week.
42.
Very positive and very fluent.
42 isn't frame winning as yet. But after the split, has he got a red middle bag?
49.
Tied to the pink. 50. Should win the frame from here.
Sixty-three.
Approaching the winning post in this frame.
64.
Snooker has acquired. Robertson hasn't done anything wrong.
70.
It's just that Andrew Higginson is flying.
71. 77.
And by winning this second frame, there's a guarantee
78.
Of play after the interval tonight for the spectators and for you at home. There'll be a break after four frames.
85. 86.
And the way he's playing at the moment, Darren, I don't think Higginson wants a break at all, does he?
No, but this is unbelievable. This is the way he's played all week.
92.
He's given Neil Robertson now something to mull over and think about. He's starting to get butterflies in the old stomach.
93. 100.
Higginson compiled a 114 in the second frame this afternoon. End of break. End of frame Higginson as well. 100. He's won the evening's first two frames.
Thank you. Frame 11, Andrew Higginson to break.
And that same was a 54 to 36 in the evening's first frame, followed by a 100 in the second.
Guarantee this afternoon Neil Robertson would have been going for this red to the left corner. Not easy by any stretch of the imagination, but I don't think he's going to be going for it tonight. He wants to, but he's having a little look at the side cushion. I think he's just going to drop onto these reds. That's what he's tried. Not bad. He has left one into the green pocket. Not easy. Might even play it in the middle pocket. It's thin, but well, he did. He played it positively as well.
Well, everything he's tried so far has come off. An attempt at a pot has he left anything? Well, a red pot, black right hand pocket. There is a red available middle bag. But the first selection.
One.
He knew exactly what he was doing. This attempt by Robertson, very nearly there.
Is that John, the look of a worried man? I think so.
Nine.
Andrew Higginson now is back in prime position again. He played two great shots, the first red and the first black. This is very positive. So the fairy tale ending, John. Could still be on at the minute.
That looks perfect.
16.
Had to be.
17.
Now he's opened up another two reds. Well, has a choice of reds.
24.
Same pocket, or red is available. Middle left-hand pocket as well.
25.
Well, Neil Robertson has done his best to combat this by
90.
Employing some safety tactics, but he's simply not keeping me quiet at all.
91.
At last, a missed pot, but it doesn't matter. Three frames are played this evening, all three won by Andrew Higginson. He now trails by just one. Six possible frames remain. It is indeed the first to nine.
He was potting them earlier on. And look where his cue ball's gone as well. Neil Robertson is starting to feel the pressure. And I think the only thing he can hope for at this moment in time is now Andrew Higginson's getting right back into this match. He starts to feel it as well.
Well, he's had a go once. No. Excellent.
Well, that's an excellent finish, but I can assure you that isn't what he played, and he's been very fortunate to land tight up behind that green ball. But he'll take it.
Higginson has left one this time. Now that does surprise me. Just a reminder of the scores in the three frames tonight. This is the attempt. 0-98, 1-100, 0-97. So he's only potted one red in three frames so far tonight.
At the moment, this Andrew Higginson, the steam train is steaming on. Another terrific long pot. And he's left himself a very similar shot. So that was the first one. He now needs a replica.
Seven.
There's no stopping him at the minute.
In potting this pink, he'll move the awkward reds just alongside, clearing the path. He's got to pot it though.
Andrew Higginson, seven.
His first miss tonight. So Neil Robertson is telling himself, compose yourself, this is an opportunity. There are reds and colours available. Take your time. Take a good look. Have a good think. And then attack.
And I do think at the minute that Neil Robertson needs an easy chance like this to get his arm going. He'll still feel like he's just walked out there. But things are not going to plan at this moment in time. All he's going to be able to play now is a safety shot. This will be hurting Neil.
Neil Robertson, one.
His escape route. Oh dear.
One.
Now things didn't go his way luckwise this afternoon. I'm referring to Andrew Higginson. They say that luck evens itself out.
Yes, John, but the fluke wasn't the shot there. It was the way
he
cannoned the pink ball, and then the pink went past the blue, and the cue ball went perfect for the blue in the other centre, but that wasn't the best shot he's ever played. That pot was made a lot more difficult due to the not very good position of his previous shot. So that's a let off.
Has Higginson covered everything? Red available. I don't think it's straight. Has an angle. Indeed so.
One.
Colours await him. Another opportunity, Darren.
At the moment, it's all one-way traffic. I did say a little bit earlier on that Andrew Higginson could get right back in this match. He'd start feeling the pressure. He's had a couple of chances already in this frame.
Three.
He's broke down. But he's nicely in position this time.
Four.
Could go quietly or in and out of balk. There isn't a brown in the way there.
Five.
9.
Did he come for this one, Darren?
I can safely say, definitely not. He played for the 2 behind the black. And he'll take it. It's not easy. And here we are, back in good position. Now we'll come down for the 2, just below the black. And all of a sudden now, this is turning into a great chance for him to level up this match at 6 frames apiece.
16.
It is, because if he takes 17. These 4 reds and big colours, you won't have to disturb the others.
Andrew Higginson, 17.
That's his first genuine miss tonight.
Well, John, you can only put this down to a little bit of pressure. He knows he had a terrific chance of levelling this match. He hasn't missed a pot in the first 3 frames, but he's had 3 real good chances in this one. He failed to put the frame away.
1.
Neil Robertson will be very relieved to have any kind of a chance. But can he take it? Due to the fact he's been sat in his chair for the last 3.5 frames, only scoring 3 points.
That isn't ideal, but does red pot, yellow pocket.
Neil Robertson, 8.
And red now becomes available for his opponent, who leads by 30 points to 9.
One.
Robertson at the moment looks very fallible.
Six. Seven. Fifteen.
He needs one more red after this black. Left himself short.
22.
A maximum of 51 left on table. The difference is 43.
23.
A snooker required. The split. Frame over.
30.
Played for, lost for tonight. Or, if you are Andrew Higginson,
35.
Played for, won for tonight. We reach the interval. What a session by Andrew Higginson. He's won all 4 frames. It's now 6 all.
What an incredible transformation. Robertson, so dominant in the opening session, frozen out. He didn't pot a ball in the 13th frame either, meaning that Higginson leads 7-6. Mind you, Robertson is 38 points to the good as we dip into the 14th. Clive Everton and Terry Griffiths take us through to a finish.
Well, if he keeps leaving that cue ball tight on the ball cushion, surely he'll get some reward. But Higginson, I think he's taking this red on. Risky.
So this is the chance that Robertson has been waiting for. He comes to the table 38 in front.
One.
Well, that's about the worst kiss he could have had. Blue won't go. Green will.
The world's against him at the
Andrew
moment.
Andrew Higginson, four.
The run of the balls. Andrew Higginson had a little bit of good running. I know that's, well, very, very unfortunate for Robertson. That was a tough green with the rest under the pressure.
Yes, it's not just the four away. Had the cue ball not dropped in, Robertson would have been on a red for sure, with every chance of securing the frame.
He's having a good look at this. I think he's taken the pot on, but he's taken a little bit more time than he has previously. He's normally just gone down there, made his decision, hit the ball. Some method in his madness there, we could say. He was playing for the pink in the middle, and he knew that he wouldn't be leaving an easy shot on for Neil. Got one in the left centre though, thin snick. Well, he's got another one on as well. Now then, has he been lucky? The answer is no. The problem with those thin cuts, Clive, is if you miss them, they're going to stay in the hole, aren't they, at that pace? But he must have fancied it.
One.
That is very well played. I think he's got options of reds in the centre or the corner. Play a lot of power, right hand side. And now he's in prime position.
Four.
And he's been scoring heavy
from these situations this evening. Black, of course, is tied up.
10.
Pink is there, readily available.
11.
Neat. Position on this next red for Higginson would be more straightforward. If he was straighter on this pink, he'd like to be on the middle red of the three, but he always knew that he'd have the lower red as a saver.
Twenty-four. Twenty-five. Thirty-one.
There goes the last of the easier reds. Develops the black with that perfectly judged cannon.
So he just flicked the black, brought it into play, but he's a little bit worried when it's going to re-spot after potting it.
46. Settle down, please.
Black on the blue spot, the highest available.
47.
Poor position shot there. Andrew looked a little disturbed when he played it. 47. Well, nothing's affecting the ball. Perfect. This clearance reminds me of a jigsaw puzzle, you know, just one thing slotting into place all the time. And didn't look on, Clive did it 5 minutes ago.
It looks on now. Red colour, and the frame is his. But this isn't easy.
60.
Well, he's just in the zone. He's popping everything.
Yes, that's one of those reds that you just don't want to leave yourself. And he knocked it in dead centre of the pocket.
67.
Two snookers needed. Well, Robertson could never have dreamt the evening would turn out like this.
72.
It's not over yet, of course, but he's going to be two down with three to play from 6-2 up.
76.
Robertson led 39-0, but it's Higginson with a break of 81, who leads by 8 frames to 6, 2 up with 3 to play, and within 1 frame of the £35,000 first prize. Higginson's break-off was intended for the Hawk cushion, but has left Robertson snookered.
He's got to be careful here. The normal shot he'd play here is off the right hand side cushion, the back cushion into the pack at the back, but there's a red available into the right centre if you don't get that right. Sure, if he's left that red on, it's quite thin. No, it's available. That's what Neil was worried about.
Higginson takes a long, hard look to determine whether that red is cuttable. It looks as if it is.
One.
Well, not too bad in the end, because Robertson had to make a very fine contact and leave position pretty well to chance.
Always walks around the table in a very confident manner, Neil Robertson. Dare say he's not feeling that confident at the moment, but he's sticking to what he does.
Nine.
Pot balls. Tremendous black he potted then.
Seventeen.
Well played. Very unlucky.
24.
You must be feeling at the moment that you've got to climb mountains. Because every time he plays a good shot, something seems to run against him on the table.
Neil Robertson, 24.
Got to be careful of the double kiss. Well,
one.
That's made a big difference. The red has dropped in when it could so easily have finished hanging over the pocket for his opponent.
Andrew Higginson, one.
You mentioned last night, Clive, in the semi-final against Steve Maguire, that fate seems to be playing a hand in things for Andrew Higginson, and that's been the case this evening a bit. A couple, I must say, with some wonderful play from him as well.
Touching ball, there was a chance to get right up behind the yellow. Perfect line and length from Robertson.
Surely looking if this red will cut in, you know, the one at the top of the pack into the left corner. Well, if he did, he caught in much too thick. Wish, but he still got it safe. A little bit of running are important when a player plays a safety not as intended and leaves his opponent in a more awkward position than if he'd played the shot well.
Well, it's very congested on the left hand side of the table.
It's very congested here in the Newport Centre this evening as well, Clive. Massive crowd in, they're really enjoying this. Lots of people, no noise. The perfect atmosphere.
Man
managed to avoid a second red. Good shot. Good as he could have done from there. He's always going to leave something on into the centre. Overcut. Overcut by a lot.
Yes, he seemed to, in the end, play that a little hastily for such an important shot, which was also pretty difficult. But at least the cue ball is somewhere near the balk cushion.
Going for this. He's got it.
Oh. He's absolutely inspired.
Andrew Higginson won.
An anticlimax, but he may have been lucky again. I'm not sure that Robertson can get through to the red to left corner. Doesn't look like it.
He's got a red in the middle though, hasn't he? He's slightly awkward bridging.
Yes, not as awkward one. As first appeared, because he could in fact just get to the centre of the cue ball.
Pretty poor shot, I must say that.
Yes, he had a big target to make the cannon on the bunch from the easy black.
Well, if he's on the red but the pink, he's been fortunate. He's cut up off the shot though.
Robertson, 8.
I wasn't quite sure if he could hit enough to get the pot in angle.
Yes, and he did miss it on the thin side. Nothing goes to the left corner. The blue snooker's Higginson on the red to the balk pocket. Robertson is very good at middle pocket pots, and Higginson has left him one.
good pot, but he should never have had a chance at that. Andrew Higginson, pretty straightforward safety. Anyway, he's got the red and he's in them.
Eight. Nine.
Well played this time.
16.
You knew we'd be on the red up the top of the table anyway.
17.
Sure. Robertson, 47 in front.
22. 23.
He's got an angle on the yellow. To take that on and try and split the four reds.
25.
Just red and black needed then to put Higginson at the snooker's required stage.
26. 33. 34.
So Robertson has won one of the frames that he needs to save the match.
41. 42.
Well, it'll do him a world of good this. It is what we'd call an easy enough frame. He's won it in comfortable and a bit of style here at the end. He hasn't been having a lot of time on the table this evening, so
49.
This could be the catalyst of a comeback 50. From Robertson.
57. 58.
With this visit, Robertson has not only secured the frame, but got his cue arm moving nicely again.
65. 67.
And the way that Robertson has won this frame suggests that the match may be about to turn.
70.
Two small but, as it proves, significant mistakes from Higginson in this
74.
Frame. He's still got to win one of the last two to get over the line.
92
clearance, Neil Robertson reduces his arrears to a single frame. Andrew Higginson now leads only by 8 frames to 7. Robertson's break off has left Higginson a safety which could go wrong. Thin off the second red out from the left hand side cushion. He'd be risking a cannon on the red nearest the cushion. Be a containing safety, but the red came back to offer this pot to Robertson.
One.
Well, he hasn't played that pot any too well. If he'd got the cue ball out of balk, he would have had a choice of balk colours.
Neil Robertson won. Foul and a miss. Neil Robertson 6.
Higginson trying to go into the side of the bunch somewhere near the pink. He doesn't want to slide off the bottom red and leave an easy one. Bit pacey really.
Yes, it's not easy to make an adjustment to the point of contact you want on the cushion. If you go like half an inch, it should have been okay, but if you go a little bit more, you'll slide off the pack like he has. And as you said, Clive, a little bit too much pace as well. Momentum is turning here, no doubt about it. Earlier on, you wouldn't have fancied Robson to make a 40 here. But now, as Andrew looks on, totally different position for Robson to be in. What's the odds here then, Clive, for 100? Come on. You're a heavy gambler. What do you think?
Well, he certainly got some momentum. But the key, of course, will be how
24.
He opens the bunch in due course.
25.
Well, he's had a bad contact then, which is... looks as if he's taken away any chance of him hitting the pack after potting the black. Took 2 or 3 inches off the pace then of the cue ball, but he's got one in the centre to keep him going.
32. Neil Robertson, 32.
Straight to middle, but put it on the jaw.
Never in that one. Not at that pace, a few gently to have turned back in, but there's another change here that Robertson has missed, and this time he's left nothing on. Not easy to run off one of the side cushions into the pack, which would be a normal shot here because there's a few loose ones about. So just keeping it safe, giving Andrew Higginson the opportunity to play a good safety off the red behind the yellow. I don't think that Neil Robertson had any options there.
Overhit that. He was intending to leave the red somewhere between the middle pocket and the pocket bottom right of picture. Anyway, it's all right.
You can see the left-hand side of the pack, but it doesn't seem to like that shot because of that red that's available in the right centre. If he hit the safety bad, he'd almost certainly leave that red on. Well, he didn't hit it bad, he hit it really well. Just clip off the green has helped the cause. The closer the white is to the bottom cushion, the more difficult the pots are for your opponent. Oh, I felt that was the wrong shot. Well, time.
Andrew Higginson,
but
5.
Has he left anything easy? I think he has this time. He's left Andrew a chance.
Oh. Is Higginson's arm tightening up at last on the brink of such a famous victory?
Certainly did that time. You could see his backhand coming through a bit tight on the cue, and well, what do you expect? He's under pressure out there. He hasn't had much table time over the last frame and a half. So Neil Robertson's long red that he took on, in the end, may turn round and win him this frame if he can knock a red in here. Looks if he's got to play one red onto the other here. There's no straightforward pot. Of course, that red, you can see now then, it's not so close to the pocket as it seemed from the other camera angle. He's got to more or less hit the cushion first with the red he's playing. No, played it well. That was not easy at any time.
One.
And he's got a pot, another good one. But the difference now, and half hour ago, was that now you fancy Robinson to make this. Right in the middle.
Three.
Plenty of easy reds to go at. Already 37 in front. Should level the match at this visit.
Four.
The leathers on the back of these pockets will need changing, won't they, after the match? He likes to give him a thump, doesn't he?
Ten.
He's got the touch there as well, don't get me wrong, but I think he's trying to make a statement out there to his opponent. When you hear them hitting the back of the pocket, it's a little shiver goes through your body.
16.
It's like gunfire.
Well, of course, you only get that noise when you hit them quite hard and they hit the centre of the pocket. It's the noise of the middle of the back of the pocket with the leather. That leather's probably thinking now, no, not me. Whoops, too late. It's in.
Nineteen. Two more reds with colours will suffice.
20.
Neil had his moment in this frame when he missed the red in the middle. But the good thing was he didn't leave anything on after it.
27.
The match is going to run the full 17 frames.
Thirty-six.
Robertson led 6-2. Higginson led 8-6.
For 43.
But it's going to be 8 all in a minute or two.
44.
And the momentum is with Robertson, who won the last frame with a break of 92. And this one, the assistance of a 32.
51.
And this unfinished half century.
52. 59. Neil Robertson, 59. And nothing.
And with that 59 break, Neil Robertson levels the match at 8-all.
Andrew Higginson to break.
This frame is going to decide whether Andrew Higginson completes one of the most remarkable stories the snooker world has ever seen, or whether Neil Robertson wins his second world ranking title, having won October's Grand Prix in Aberdeen. Higginson's break-off has restricted Robertson to one red.
A plant here, Andrew, to the left of the reds there. Looks a bit risky from the angle he's attacking it from. If he was straight on to the first red, you can always sort of make some sort of plant, but you can see it's going to the right hand side of that pocket. So it would mean he'd have to make an adjustment of the angle the first red hits the second to take it in there. At this stage, doesn't look a great choice to me. If it goes in, they'd be calling him a hero.
Well, very doubtful whether that was the right shot choice, not least because he couldn't count on position on a colour.
Sometimes you're forced to take those plants on, Clive, when you're trapped, but then you could have just played a safety off the second red of the plant, because obviously if he couldn't get rid of the plant, he was leaving an option for Neil Robertson to go for it. But he could have, he had an easy safety off that red, and well, he may come to regret it, he may not. Certainly given with that shot there, Neil Robertson, the first shot at it.
One.
Not ideal, he just clipped a red there on the way through. Otherwise the white would have been up towards blue and pink, which was his intention. He can still pot them, but I think he's playing yellow now.
Three.
It's all happening out there now. He's come through a gap in the reds and he's on the blue. Time, he's got a head of steam up now.
Nine.
Higginson has scored only 7 points in the last two frames from 8-6 up.
Ten. Can you be quiet up there, please?
Not quite sure if the pink grease spot's here, if he takes it on. If not, it would go on the black spot, which would tie things up a bit more. So still a bit to do. Well, it does go on
16.
His spot, and I think it is possibly available into centres or the corners.
17.
He's on the pink, but he hasn't got a favourable angle, I think, to get on the next red or split them out.
Twenty-three.
Robertson building up a useful lead from a chance he was left by Higginson's risky attempt at a plant.
Higginson may, of course, have thought it may be the only chance he may get, and if you fancy it,
30.
Then he should go for it. It's easy to sit here and criticise somebody for playing a shot, but I think everybody in the game feels the same. If you think you're going to get it, go for it. Commit yourself.
36.
What if you'd have turned that down and not got another shot? Not get another chance in the deciding frame, so... Now then, this is clearing the black spot. Oh.
37.
Has he got the kiss? Can he get to the pot in angle of the black? That's what he played for. It's tight.
Well, from here, it looks as if he can't. But it can look different from right behind the shot.
If there's any doubt, he's got to play safe. It's the only thing that was going to stop Robertson, the way he's been playing the last few frames. And he looks really bang on form at the moment, at just the right time. Played the right shot, just caught the, should have caught the reds in the middle, and that one would have cleared away and left the black on.
Robertson, 37.
Well, Higginson could just get through to that long red.
It was worth a try.
Immaculate length on the Robertson safety.
Yes, and if you couple his safety with his devastating potting, he's a tough opponent for anybody these days, Robertson.
Yes, he's going to be a contender for major titles for many years. He'll be seventh in the provisional rankings if he wins, eighth if he loses. Robertson was hoping that that long pot was going to create the chance for him to clinch this decider, in which he leads by 37.
Yes, but once again he's left Andrew Higginson very awkward. He's, whatever he goes for, if he doesn't get it, he's going to leave Robertson on. He's going for it. Well, he hedges his bet there a bit. He could have dropped that in and stayed on the black, but he would have been leaving something on. Taking the cue ball back up the table, it just put a little more degree of difficulty in the pot.
And also in the position. But if he gets this right, Robertson is a strong favourite for frame and match.
One.
Played with left of centre striking to avoid cannoning another ball.
I've done a lot wrong in the last 2.5 frames, Andrew Higginson. The odd thing here and there, but Robertson has gone up a few gears, to say the least.
Three. Four.
Robertson intends to make this the last visit to the match.
Well, he'd like that back again. Left himself a bit to do here now.
Ten.
Tried to come back further across.
Still got two reds on, of course, but they're not the types you want when he was in prime position.
11.
Once again, he's excellent potting. Pulls him through. He probably thinks those shots are very easy, says Clive. If you pot that well, he just feels anything at the moment, you're going to pot it. And he has potted most of them last few frames. He's overdone it a bit. Hit that green extremely well, but you would have liked to be on these three reds at different angles. So close to this red, it's not so easy to pick up the correct potting angle. And he hasn't.
Neil Robertson, 14.
I'm amazed he's played that with the white down into the box. And as it's turned out, the balls have run kind for him. He certainly didn't play that, because he cut the red too thin, so if he'd have cut it at the right angle, he wouldn't have gone behind the brown.
Foul and a miss. Neil Robertson, 4.
Red may be on for the far corner. If it is, he would need only black in addition.
Well, you wouldn't think Andrew Higginson would play that shot as poorly again. He'd probably come behind the reds and leave Neil nothing to go at. He's looking at the one in the centre now. He's putting him back.
Well, maybe the left-hand red didn't go to the far corner, although it was very close to it.
I'm not actually sure how much you can see, Andrew. Is that right, you, Neil?
Yeah. Well, he's overhit it slightly. But he's turned out okay, so he's still in it. Surely you can't come back from here. He was 6-2 behind and somehow found some of his best form to come back into it. But he's been shut out for the last few frames.
Generous applause from this big crowd, who sense that there may just be one final twist in the tail of this match.
He could be here, because this is a difficult safety. He was always pushing balls across the right side of the table. And as it turned out, left Andrew Higginson a very difficult red. May not take it on, but I don't think you can see any other reds.
Last chance for Higginson that, and it was a difficult one. Surely this is it. Robertson needs only a red and a colour. Andrew Higginson has had a great week, beating
7.
A former world champion, John Higgins, and two other members of the top 16, Alistair Carter and Stephen Maguire.
8.
And he was within one frame of the title itself. But it's Neil Robertson from 2 down with 3 to play.
14. 15.
And he's going to walk away with the £35,000 first prize. Just a wonderful match. Robertson wins by 9-8. It's his title, but in many ways, it's been Higginson's week.
Neil Robertson prevails, but ignore the old adage that no one remembers who finishes second. Higginson will forever be linked with the 2007 Welsh Open, a winner even in defeat. Congratulations to both, and especially to Robertson, twice a champion this season after breaking through at the Grand Prix in October. It's been tremendous entertainment, but all good things come to an end. From Newport, it's goodbye.